Last week, I talked with Cheryl Rhodes about his new virtual book publishing company, Absolutely Amazing eBooks. Now, one of the authors that you'll find in the short story collection is my next guest this morning, Lucy Burdett. Now, she actually worked as a clinical psychologist before turning over to mystery writing. She's been very successful at it and has had 10 books published within the last 10 years. Lucy, it's so great having you on this
morning. It's so nice to be here. Thank you.
Lucy, I find it so interesting that you went from psychology to becoming a mystery writer. How did this happen?
It started with bad golf. I was learning the game. I was terrible. I spent so much time and money on it that I had to do something with it. And the idea came up of writing a mystery, my favorite genre to read, and writing it about an aspiring golfer who had family issues that kept her from performing the way she should have. So that book came out in 2002. It was called Six Strokes Under.
And Six Strokes Under, it just took off for you. It led you right into the career of mystery writing.
Right, yes. And then I was hooked on that. I get hooked on whatever I'm doing. So I had a second series about a clinical psychologist in Connecticut, and now I'm writing the Key West Food Critic mystery series.
And you are very well known for those Food Critic mystery series. Let's talk about your main character in these books.
Okay, my main character is a food critic who's trying to make enough to be able to stay on the island, which I guess a lot of people do. And the first book came out last January. That was An Appetite for Murder. And then in September, Death in Four Courses. And coming in May, Topped Chef.
Ooh. Sounds good. Now, are the restaurants based on real restaurants here in Key West?
So the restaurants are places that I've been, food that I've loved. It's a good excuse for doing that kind of research. The only time I would not put in a real place would be if she has to write a bad review or if someone gets poisoned in the restaurant.
So then those are made up.
Those are made up, right. Okay.
How many more books do you think will be in this series?
There are two more under contract, so I'm working on the fourth one right now.
Okay. Any idea what's going to be next then for you?
After those two? I hope if it sells well enough, I'll keep writing them. It's really a lot of fun.
Yes, I've heard that, and I'm excited. You gave me a copy this morning, so I'm excited to read one of my copies. Now, what do you have published through Absolutely Amazing eBooks?
Absolutely Amazing eBooks published a collection of Key West writers' short mystery stories. It's called Murder in Key West, and the story that I have in there is called The Itinerary. And actually, this was the bridge between the psychology series and coming up with the idea of the Key West series, because the detective from Connecticut is sent down to Key West on a vacation that he doesn't want, and what he does not want to do is walk Duval Street or do anything the tourists do, so he butts into a case and tries to help the Key West police solve it.
Okay, that sounds very interesting. Yeah. I'll definitely have to check that out. Now, Lucy, do you do any psychology anymore? Are you totally? That's another life.
That's another life, except that I put most of my characters in therapy, and that generally helps them.
Okay, you do. Now, how do you stay disciplined, Lucy, as a writer?
Discipline is I have a deadline, so I have no choice.
You have no choice.
No. I set it up so I figure out how many words I need to get done in a day or a week, and then I keep at it until it's done.
Any chance of you doing something besides mystery writing?
I have a book that's half written that is more of a thriller than a mystery. And so if I get a break, I might go back to that one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, would you say you like this life as a writer better than your life as a psychologist?
Oh, that's a tough one. I loved being a psychologist and really helping people understand themselves and clear up some of the baggage that they take with them. But I can do the same thing as I write. I feel like I can use that psychology, not just helping the characters, but fleshing characters out. And also, you may have noticed books and movies, they make psychologists look ridiculous. So if I can write a story where the psychologist is a good, decent person doing a good job, then I feel like I'm helping that profession, too.
Oh, yeah, you are. You are helping them. Now, Lucy, if people want more information on you, they can check out your website, correct?
My website is www.lucyburdette.com. Yes.
Okay. Would you have any advice for people out there, Lucy, who they might be in a profession that they want to get away from and they love writing? I mean, would you have advice for them to make that transition?
I would say take some classes because everybody thinks they can write a book. Mm-hmm. But there's a lot to learn, and then practice. It's like learning the violin or anything else. You're not born a good writer. Find some people who will give you some feedback, and don't rush to publish.
I like it. Great advice, Lucy.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for being here with me this morning and
it
sharing
all. It was a pleasure.
I'm going to take a quick break right now. I'll be right back after these messages, so don't go away.